Okay, that's a little bit of a close-up of the burl. I'm not sure how good you can see that, but it protrudes out of the log, oh, probably 6 inches, maybe 150 mil. So I don't know. It might be just all on the outside of the tree and not go into the timber on the inside. I don't know. But anyway, we'll find out. Wondering what we're going to find inside this. Anyway, I'll just cut the top of the burl off, like sort of a little bit higher than the actual log itself, and have a look. And hopefully this burl goes down into the timber a little bit so we can get a nice slab with something in it. But anyway, don't know until we try. You may have noticed I had the burl facing downwards to start, and so I'm going to take one cut across the back of it, so as you can see now, it sits flat and square on the sawmill and doesn't rock around. Yeah, most interesting patterns and so forth. Unfortunately, this lighter material is actually the dry rot. Like, you can actually, that's bark there, but see, that's dry rot in there. It picks out a rot, but you can dig that out, I guess, and fill it with resin. And interesting chopping boards. So let's hope this pattern here, see, that's nice and solid there, that's good, that bit. And same over here, that's really good and hard. Yes, dear. Oh, it's not the wife. Hey, be quiet. Noisy fan club this morning. Oh, wow. They're having a real go. Anyway, we'll get down into some boards, and hopefully this sort of grain sort of goes down into the log a little ways, and that might have something decent in there, I don't know. Anyway, I guess we're going to find out together. Thank you. Now you've still got a bit of dry rot happening here in the center. You can pick away as soft as that stuff there, but that's hard as there, and just the dry rot. That little knot there is what caused the entire burl. Something got in there, and then the tree just didn't like it. A fungus or something, probably. Probably dry rot fungus, if there's such a thing, I'm not sure. And that's what's actually caused the burl. But I think this slab here, which was closest to the top, it's the most interesting batten. These all look pretty good. I like this. But you'd have to wire brush and see how you poke right through that. That's no good, that stuff. But rock hard next to it, but get all that out. And do it with a bit of resin. Probably come up quite nice. Anyway, I mean, like, some of the patterns of these. Yeah, that's beautiful. Anyway, we'll flip this. I'll move these off the bench here. I have to flip that one right over again, that main one. Take off another one or two slabs off that side. Same thickness as these. Then I'll stand it up at 90 degrees and cut slabs out of it. So, it's in the end. You don't want this center here, right? That always splits, as you can see, but that'll ruin your slabs. If you keep slabbing through here, those just open up and split the whole thing in half. So I'll take another two slabs from here. I'll cut these at 30 mil. Then I'll stand it up and I'll slab it this way to make some boards out of here and here. So if you make a table or something, you can put one of these live edges on the edge of the table, one on the other edge of the table, and fill it in with these boards, see? And that's the centerpiece is just firewood. That's all you can use it for. All right, I'll flip it over. Okay, we just cut some boards out of that. From this log I got 5 slabs, 6 boards and 3 burl slabs. Please leave a comment on your thoughts of what we could possibly make from these slabs. If you like this sort of content, please like, subscribe and share, and also take the time to look at my channel and see the other interesting things that I get up to. See you in the next one.